Welcome to Okuma. My name is Dorian Wilger and I'm working in the application department. Today, I want to introduce you our own Okuma IT products. Have you ever noticed how much time gets lost for setup and programming new work pieces directly on the machine? These times have a high effect on your costs. To reduce these times, Okuma developed the 3D virtual monitor and the advanced OneTouch IGF. Together, these two products are a full digital workplace where you can prepare and program your machine, including a full collision check. To introduce these products to you, we will simulate the full work preparation process step by step. The special thing about our system compared to conventional programming systems is that we work on an exact digital twin of the machine. This we can do due to the fact that not only the IT products, also the CNC control of the machine is completely developed and programmed by Okuma. In the first step, we will now load all data of existing tools and clamping devices via network directly from the machine into our database. Here, I want to mention that both IGF and the 3D virtual monitor work with a common database so that the operator only has to create tools once. Together, we are now creating our project OAD1. We will program the workpiece in full dialog. For this, we use the IGF software, which is used in exactly the same way for programming on the machine. We set the blank dimensions and then we draw the finished part contour into the blank. Here, for the turning operation, we draw the contour step by step. The change from turning to milling operation goes smooth. Here, you can now also draw the milling contour by hand. Or, as in our example, read the finished contour as DXF file. For threads, for example, you have the possibility that you only specify the position of the threads and select the thread size. All other parameters are already stored in a database, so the software can now independently determine the centering and pre-drilling, which reduces the work for the operator. Features such as bolt hole circles or lines are also supported. The software now has all the necessary information about the blank and the finished part and can now independently select the right tools from the database in order to program the entire contour. Then, let's take a look in the programming simulation to see whether we like how the IGF has chosen the machining sequence or if we want to make changes. This looks really good, so we can now generate a NC program. In order to simulate not only the programming, but also the full process, we switch to the 3D virtual monitor. In the 3D virtual monitor, you can not only check programs from the IGF for collisions, but also all NC programs from a CAM system or those which were programmed directly on the machine. For the chuck, we use the one which is already mounted on the machine and are now looking for the white jaws from our inventory. In this case, we don't have anything suitable and will order new jaws for this project. There, we can now download the 3D data for this directly from the supplier's website and use our STL check to prepare it with just a few clicks for importing into the database. After we have imported the jaws into our system, we now mount them on our chuck and tell the software how many jaws we have. Then we create the blank. Here you can either enter the dimensions or upload it as an STL file, for example for casted form parts or pre-machined parts. After that, all we have to do is determine the stickout lengths and the position for our offset. The meshing model, including all offsets, is identical to the real machine, so the clamping setup and all zero points specified in the 3D virtual monitor can be taken directly from the machine. Now that we have made all the settings for the blank and for the clamping, we can select our NC program and test the process, including collision check. Here we can already see that we have to increase the stickout length of the workpiece, and there was also a problem with the drilling. We later get all of these collisions listed in the collision history. Additionally, the 3D virtual monitor is also able to support you in process planning due to the fact that we receive a very accurate cycle time calculation, because all cycle times such as swiveling the head and tool changes are stored in the data of the digital twin of the machine. For a closer look, we can also display and synchronize all collision points again individually. In our case, the existing U-drill is not long enough. Thanks to the preparation in the 3D virtual monitor, you can now identify and fix this problem early on by ordering a longer drill. If this problem would have been discovered later on the machine, we would unavoidably have a machine downtime which cost us time and money. The tool suppliers also provide 3D model data for their tools directly on their websites, which we can prepare with little effort for import into the database by our tool model maker. Here, the different areas of the tool, such as cutting edge, body and holder, are defined, so that the 3D virtual monitor and later the collision avoidance system of the machine can accurately assess which movements are permitted and which are not. There is also the option of reducing the number of triangles if you have very detailed models, in order not to unnecessarily increase the computational effort of the software. Finally, we import this model into our tool database. Now we replace the existing drill with the new created tool. And we increase the stickout length of the workpiece a little bit and then run the process simulation again. The collision history is empty. That means there are no further problems and we can now generate the process files. In addition to the NC program, this also includes an update of all models for the collision avoidance system of the machine and a tool and clamping device setup sheet with which the operator can prepare all required tools and set up the workpiece clamping. And here you can see the machining of our demonstration workpiece on our Maltes U4000. Thank you for the time you spent with us. For further information, contact us on info@okuma.eu.